Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In electrochemistry, conductors plays a very important role in conduction of electricity. And what are those and how they are being classified, let us see. So to understand conductor, we should know the definition of it, and it says that the substance that allows electricity to pass through it with or without chemical changes are known as conductors. For example, Fe, aqueous solution of NaCl, etc. This all are known as conductors, which allow electricity to pass through them. You cannot pass electricity through a polymer like plastic, because electricity are not being passed through it, because this plastic doesn't consist of free electrons or free ions that would help to conduct the electricity, and hence they are bad conductors or known as insulators. But these conductors are being classified into two types, which is electronic conductor and electrolytic conductor. The both conducts electricity, but let us see the deep knowledge about what is electronic conductor and what is electrolytic conductor. Electronic conductor says that the substance, usually a metal, that allows electricity to pass through it due to flow of electrons is known as electronic conductor. Since we know metal consists of very few many free electrons that helps in the conduction of electricity. So if you pass electricity through it, then the many electrons that are present in it, the many free electrons that are present in it, are aligned in a one direction. And because of that, electricity is conducted through the substance or through the metal. But the main important thing is, when electricity is passed through the metal, then there is no chemical change that has been observed in the metal. For example, if we pass current through copper, and if we pass current through any kind of metal which conducts electricity in a very efficient way, then there is no chemical change that we could observe. For example, if I would say that when electricity is passed through copper, then copper is not been oxidized or copper is not been is reduced. It remains as copper as it is, unless it is dipped in a electrolytic solution, or it is represented in a or mixed with an electrolytic conductor. So in that case, the metal doesn't changes because of electricity. So this makes to know that what is electronic conductor. Now let's study about the next one. The next is electrolytic conductor. And what does electrolytic conductor means? It says that the substance, usually electrolytes, and electrolytes are those substances which consist of which are nothing but the salts which consist of cations as well as anions, and when they are dipped in a aqueous form, or when they are mixed in water to form an aqueous solution, they conduct electricity. So they allows electricity to pass through it due to flow of ions, because as I said, the electrolytes are made of cation and anion. So that particular ion will move towards the respective electrodes, and hence this kind of electrolytes, or basically we could say this kind of conductors, are known as electrolytic conductors. Example, if I could say that aqueous solution of NaCl, aqueous solution of CuS4, aqueous solution of ZnSO4, or molten NaCl solution, this all are known as electrolytic solution, because this consists of cation and anion. But when we pass current through it, this cation and anion can undergo redox reaction, or can undergo oxidation and reduction, and hence the chemical change can be observed in this. The one which is present in aqueous form can be now be converted into a metallic form, or can be now converted into an elemental form. So this is the property of the electrolytic conductors. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got an idea what is electrolytic conductor and what is electronic conductor. And thank you, and please share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.